Hi everyone, I am Andre from Voodoo Games, and this is the second unboxing video for our game Isles of Terror. Last time I've shown you the contents of the base game, and in this video we are going to have a closer look at the adventure expansions. There are basically three expansions: the Emerald Brood, the Eight-Legged Goddess, and the Tales from the Isles of Terror as a single basically adventure book without any additional contents. And I think to start with, we are going to take a closer look at the Emerald Brood box. Each adventure expansion comes with their own adventures basically, and also their own set of locations and also exploration cards and all that stuff. So when we open it up, we can see, first of all, there are the two adventure books. Within these books you will find three new adventures that are also linked as a campaign, so you can again play them as a campaign, or you just play them separately as individual scenarios, let's say. Both books are in each of the adventure expansions. There's one in English and one in German. Then we have a set of tokens. With this expansion you get ritual tokens. That's kind of a new mechanic. And you also get portals, which lets you basically travel from one place on the island to another place where there is another portal. Then we have a few new locations all over here. New terror tokens and a new scenario token. And of course our terror board. Again, this one has one English side and one German. Then we have two sets or decks of cards, one in German, one in English. And these are basically the exploration cards you will need for playing the campaign. And it also contains new location cards. So you have the portal, you have, what is it, an occult statue. So maybe we can see it here. You have a black tower, and then there's a couple of new minions. That's also very important. We have new minion types, which are basically going to appear during the campaign and the scenarios. And yeah, all the exploration cards I was talking about. So 36 new exploration cards that describe new situations when you discover different areas on the island. So inside the box we have two compartments, one for each of the decks. Obviously you can leave out one deck if you don't need this language, and then you have one larger compartment where you can store all the punched out tokens. Yeah, that's how the Emerald Brood looks like. Basically we have the same content for the Eight-Legged Goddess. It's just a different campaign, of course. So in this campaign you will have three more scenarios to play, three more adventures. Again, they are linked as a campaign, and again we have an English and a German adventure book describing all the details. So this expansion comes with new mechanics as well. We have web tokens that will hinder your movement, and we will have poison and antidote tokens that are having some influence on the combat. And then we have new locations and new tokens for the terrors and scenario token. Again, there is one of the terror boards, double-sided with the English and German rules, and the two deck of cards, the German one and the English one. I'm going to open this one as well so you can see a few of the cards. Some new locations like a spider's lair, a sanctuary, and stuff like that. It's all in there. Then new exploration cards and new minions you're going to face. So basically this is all about spiders and some spider priests and spider warriors and a whole spider cult that you can encounter in this campaign. Yeah, so this is how these two expansions look like. The last thing that we have as kind of an adventure expansion are the Tales of the Isles of Terror adventure books. They are basically just two single books that you could add on during the Kickstarter. And they have no other components with them, so they are just describing five new adventures that you can play. They are not linked as a campaign. So basically, as you can see, they do not have predetermined minions that you will face during each of the scenarios. Basically, the idea is that you can just use whatever minions you would like to use. So basically, you can play all these adventures with the core base game or with any of the other adventure expansions using their minions. Yeah, that's about it for this. Yeah, I hope this has given you some more insight on what the adventure expansions look like. Next time we will take a closer look at the faction expansions, and then there will be one more video where I will show you the miniatures finally. Thanks for watching. Bye.